Hello friends, and welcome to this tutorial of SlideScope. In this particular tutorial, we are going to discuss the difference between live and extract connections in Tableau. This video is a part of our Tableau series in which we are trying to explain you how you can use Tableau for data visualization. And so if you are using Tableau or if you are learning Tableau, then you will see in this corner here, you will see live and extract connections. So this particular video will explain you the meaning of live and extract connections. So the meaning of live is connected to our data source. Live fetching of data while analyzing it will be on runtime, and data can be on a server or on a cloud. So suppose you are connected to a data that is stored on a server or a cloud, so in that case process speed can be slower for large and slow data sources. In case of things like live feeds, we will see the latest data. So that is one advantage. So suppose you are connected with a live API that tells data or that fetch data from any particular source, and it tells on the live runtime that about some value like value of temperature, value of humidity, anything. So if the main benefit of using live connections is you will get the latest values, but in case of extract, the information will be extracted to Tableau, and in case of extract we can refresh the data, but for refresh an internet connection is needed, or if you are connected to an internet source, a snapshot of data is saved in the history of Tableau. So in case of extract there is a refresh process, in case of live there is a refresh process, but that process is different for live and extract, and that's why we are going to demonstrate you in this session. So for the sake of simplicity, we have a very basic data source, and this data source has a name of some countries: India, USA, UK and Canada. So this first column, this first name countries will be considered as tab column by Tableau. So open Tableau. And remember, this is a very, very basic video. This is for understanding the difference between live and extract. So there are many other videos in our channel that are for advanced analysis process, but this is basics of Tableau. You can categorize this video as a part of basics of Tableau. So click on Microsoft Excel. So because we have to connect, we want to connect to a Excel source. If you want to connect to any type of source, then that type of source can be selected from the Tableau window. Now we have selected this. In that data there is one sheet, and that's why it is automatically selected. Now one thing, refresh data source. Now suppose I make some changes here. This is some value, this is some random value that is assigned to these countries. Let's say 70, let's say 65, to UK let's say 56, and to Canada let's say 72. So these are some random values. There is no meaning to these values, but these are assigned to our data source. Now when you will go to Tableau, click anywhere, what you can see, you will not see any changes in the data source, but what you can see is you can see a small icon here, and this icon represents globe. So because the name of these countries is spelled correctly, that's why Tableau is able to understand that it is a geospatial data, and that's why it has assigned this symbol to it. For strings it tells ABC. So we have discussed about data types and basics of data types in our previous videos, and we will create a separate video for data types, but in this part we are just focused with live and extract connections. Now click on this icon, and what it will do is now you have the values that are the latest values that you have in your data source, because we are connected to a live connection. So this thing will work anyhow. Now we are connected to a live connection, and first I will explain you details in a live connection, then I will explain you details in extract connection. Now in live connection, go to sheet, and when you will go to sheet, what will happen? You can drag this here. So now you can see countries, Canada, India, UK, USA, and now you can drag values also. So now you can see we have data of Canada, India, UK, USA, and there are some random values to it, right? And this is sum of values. So we are not discussing about these things here. In case of Xiaomi, you will see various type of graphs are available here, and the legend will show you that the lightest shade of blue represents the lowest value of data, and the darkest shade of blue represents highest value in the data. And we can do this, right? So now go back to this table view here. This is basic table view here. So now let us try to make some changes in our data source. Let's add another country here, let's add Germany here, and give it a value of, let's say, 67. This is a random value. So we have given a value of 67 to Germany. Now again, right click on your sheet, you will find nothing. Right click on your this part, you will find nothing in your dimensions, in your measures, you will find nothing. Dimensions are basically values that are qualitative, and measures are values that is quantitative. Those values which you can represent in quantity are, or those values which are numeric values are mostly represented in measures, and those values that are string or that show something more qualitative value are in the dimensions part. But to change, now we know that we there is some changes in the data source, there are some changes in the data source. So in case of a live connection, what you can do is click on this part just below your data. This is the name of your data, and click this part and click refresh. Now what you can see, you can see that the values are now changed. And now if you will go to the map view or the map graph, now you can see Germany is also included in your data set, right? So this is how we create live connections, and this is the benefit of live connection. You can simply refresh from this part, right? So if you, or you can say if you are connected to a live connection and you want to see whether there are some changes in the data to be analyzed, you can click refresh here, right? So this is our live connection. Now let's delete it, or let us open it once again. So I am quitting tab, I am closing Tableau without making any changes, and let's click no. So now let's open Tableau once again. So we made no changes in the data, that's why we don't see anything here. Again, go to Microsoft Excel, again connect to the same data source. Now since we added Germany, we have some value here, and now live and extract. Now this time I want my data to be extract, right? So extract will include all data. What extract will do is, extract will keep a copy of your data in the history of Tableau. So in this case, this data will be in the history of Tableau, and whatever analysis we are doing will be done with the help of that history value in the Tableau itself. Now the process is simple. Go to sheet to analyze things, and now what you can see here is Tableau data extract. This is very important. You can see now Tableau is keeping an extract of your data, and in the history of Tableau, in this particular part of Tableau. So we have some previous extracts also. So this will be saved as sheet 1 live extract dot hyper. Save it. So now you understand the difference between live and extract. In case of live, nothing is saved in your database, in your file, nothing is saved in your folder, everything is live. All you have to do is you have to simply refresh your data source. But in case of extract, something will be saved in your sheet, so it will take some space. But the advantage is the analysis in this case will be faster, because again, it depends on many factors, like in case of live, what is your internet speed, what is the size of data, how many columns or how many rows we are trying to analyze. So now the decision is yours, and on the basis of various things that we have discussed, on the basis of your understanding of live and extract, you can decide whether you want to go with live or you want to go with extract. Now let me demonstrate that. Now drag countries here and drag values in the in this part, and go to this and simply make it a table view. So for the sake of simplicity, we are not going with any type of fancy graphs. We are just sticking to the table view. Here the data has some sorting here, and that sorting is by name, as you can see, CGI. So alphabetical sorting is automatically there. Now again, we'll go to our data source. Let us try to add one country here, Japan. And in case of Japan, let's say value is 69. So again, we have saved this. Go to Tableau again. Again, we know right clicking here will not help us. Let's try to do the same thing that we did in the case of live. Refresh. Again, refresh. So you can see that instead of doing that thing which we did in live and it worked for us, now nothing, we know that there is a change in the data source, but that is not happening here. So now what you have to do is, in case of extract, if you are connected with the extract connection, then only this option will be visible. And now go to extract and hit refresh. Now what it's saying here, let me read it. The entire contents of the extract will be replaced during the extract refresh. That means whatever you have saved in the extract will be replaced with a new data. If you have modified filters or hidden fields since the last extract was taken, you might have data that will be lost during the extract refresh. So if you have anything that you have that you did in that particular part, so if you have some hidden fields there, so I will explain about hidden fields in the basics of Tableau in our upcoming videos. But right now you understand it, right? Whatever you have saved, it will be replaced with a new value. So now replace with a new value, and now after a few seconds you can see the value of Japan is here. Now if we'll go to the map view, now you can see that you have Japan here, you have India, USA and Canada, Germany and what, UK. Make it full screen, and now this is some data for you. 56 is the lowest value, 72, it can be anything. It is just sample data. So I hope now the meaning of live versus extract is clear to you. And if you have any doubts, please let me know. And please comment with your doubts in the comment section. And thanks for watching once again.